beda tradisi, beda treatment from Donna, your wife. Di situ. What you like to get treatment from Donna, your wife?
Treatment. I like massage. I like when she cook my favorite food. I like when she shopping for me something what I need. I like.
Karena dia nggak suka banget shopping.
Yeah, I like. What else I like?
I don't know. Maybe not something physically. What you like?
I have list actually. I have list some in my Google Notes. I'm writing my favorite food, yeah, something like this.
No, I mean this is some physical. Every girl can
physical.
Be doing. Yeah, this one something like every girl can be doing. But what you the unique thing what you like from Donna?
I like the most if she listened me so good. If I'm exciting of my work or some meeting or some, the best what she can do to me is just listen me and that like oh really like this is.
But I good listener most. Or not?
Yes, you mostly you good listener.
The question that this is so many as well asking people. What you like from each other? You first.
I just tell now. So your turn.
Okay, for me, buat aku sih yang aku paling suka dari dia karena dia tuh hard worker. Yeah, even sometime kayak ngeselin gitu ya, terlalu kerja gitu. Dia tuh kerja. Tapi di sisi lain itu tuh ada kelebihan dia gitu. Jadi itu salah satu yang bikin aku suka, dia tuh pekerja keras dan dia tuh suka dengan kerjaannya. Itu paling penting sih buat aku. Karena kalau dia nggak suka, buat apa dong dia kerja, pasti dia banyak komplain. Tapi karena dia suka, dia tuh nggak pernah namanya komplain dengan kerjaannya. Dan dia tuh selalu bangga untuk kerjaannya, apapun itu, kerjaan yang baru atau yang lama. Dia tuh setiap menemukan hal baru itu, dia tuh excitingnya tuh tinggi gitu, exciting person banget. You really exciting person, you know, really like, really what I like from you. You really hard worker. And terus yang banyak sih sebenarnya kelebihan dia yang aku suka, dia itu typical orang yang pendengar baik juga sih, jadi pendengar yang setia juga. You really listener, I really like on that. Dan dia itu supportive. Dia sangat support apapun yang aku lakuin. Itu sih yang bikin aku suka banget. Dan gak pernah ada batasan untuk apa yang aku mau lakuin gitu. That is the best one. Next question. So for you, that's all? Nothing's what you like from me?
Yeah, I have much more things. I like how you take care of Joy, how you take care of me, of our house, and really can be focused on my things and don't worry about your things. So I feel safety. Yeah, and also that I like to going out with you to meet my friends, and I like spend time together with you. I like to talking about psychology. And
yeah,
I like if you study something from me, yeah, if you get some of my experience, which is I earned so long time. Yeah, it's like the minimum what I can be just fine now.
Yeah, aku juga suka dari dia karena bisa belajar sesuatu dari dia itu luar biasa. Dia banyak banget experience-nya. Okay, next question. What you don't like each other? This is the upside.
Good question.
Okay. Don't say a lot.
No, actually, it's not a lot because I don't try to change her and she don't try to change me. This is our agreement. So at least the things what she, what I don't like to her, at least she's not doing to me. But she can do it up to her. So
like example what? Oh, no hair! Guys, no hair!
No, I mean, if I get 5 years we together, yeah, and like we'll be writing the everything what I do like, I will have the
all list big list. Like, yeah,
I will be have big list. Mm-hmm. But all of this list, at the moment, yeah, we solution already. We already handle each by
we
each,
improve,
each
yeah,
by right. each. We improve, 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 and that's not mean. That from this moment it will be never happens problem. No, like life is changing. Like we have another baby or we move to another place, new situation, new coronavirus, whatever. New situations make new situations happens make can be make new conflict. So at the moment everything is good because
yeah,
we
but
have
something
our
maybe
technique
you
to
just,
solution.
Like what you said, like you cannot be changed, but you don't like on that what? Just a small example. Like
yeah,
one, two, three.
Like I don't like if she expects something from me if I not promise her to do.
Yeah.
But last month she already fixed it, you know. So for me it was the biggest problem with her last year, and finally we find understanding about this. At the moment, I like everything.
Oh, really?
Yes. For today. Let's see tomorrow.
You like my bracket?
Yes, no problem.
Okay, kalau dari aku sendiri, apa yang aku nggak suka dari dia? Mungkin ya, dulu nggak bermasalah buat aku kalau dia tuh nggak... dia orangnya nggak suka shopping yang pertama, jadi aku tuh harus shopping buat dia. Itu yang pertama. Terus yang kedua, it's not something big deal, it's bukan masalah yang besar, cuman yang ya udah biasa lah, masih maksudnya masih bisa dihandle dan kita udah tahu solusinya gitu. Kayak misalkan dia paling nggak suka kayak misalkan abis dari mana gitu bajunya digantung, aku suruh gantung di hanger yang dia pokoknya khusus buat dia. Dia tuh paling males kalau lihat berantakan gitu. Jadi I still have to do that gitu. Kayak aku tuh masih harus ngelakuin itu gitu. Jadi double gitu, kayak aku harus ngurusin si Joy juga, harus ngurusin dia juga untuk hal sekecil itu gitu. It's a small thing like that guys. Not really like it, but it's not big deal. We still handle it, and sometimes I really like it that you doing like last time. Wash your shoes by yourself. That's I so appreciate for that. Karena kalau udah punya anak sama belum punya anak tuh beda. Jadi sesuatu yang tadinya aku bisa kerjain ngebantu dia, sekarang itu nggak sebisa kayak dulu gitu. It's different. It's before kids and after. So that's why before I always take care of that. Never asking you to doing this, yeah, home thing. And now I just need help little bit. But of course, everything depends of my question as well or my asking to you how do you have to do. Mm-hmm. Last time you even happy, yeah, to clean by your own. Yeah, when you have times, I mean, of course.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, next question.
How many questions you have?
Okay, cara mengatasi perbedaan saat ada masalah, ya. Who often get the explanation and idea?
To have different opinion is normal. Everybody have their universe inside of their head, and it's normal to have different opinion. Yeah. So
yeah,
first
we often, really often,
it's normal.
Really often.
Then
yeah.
If something you do better than me, like in cooking, I'm just can be just trust you and believe you and follow what you give me. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If something I feel I'm no better than you, then I mostly keep going my opinion like stronger. But of course, I hear your feedback. And yeah, sometimes I can be wrong in something what even I know better. Yeah.
Jadi so, buat kita sih mostly is we talking, ya. Yeah? We talking and we listen to each other. Like let our couple first talking. Like which one who first wanna explain about this situation, and then after that me. Like example dia dulu, terus nanti aku gitu loh. Jadi saling mendengarkan dulu satu sama lain. Pas lagi ada masalah itu, persepsinya dia apa dari masalah ini dan persepsi aku apa dari masalah ini. Jadi setelah itu kita tahu gitu loh untuk jalan keluarnya itu seperti apa gitu. Sometimes kita kayak write downs in the paper, kita selalu tulis di buku kayak apa aja sih yang dia mengerti dari masalah ini, kenapa ada masalah ini. Terus nanti setelah dari list ini kita cari solusinya bareng-bareng gitu. Setelah kita saling mendengarkan opinion satu sama lain gitu biasanya. Yeah, so far. Mm-hmm. That is the way our. Okay, next, how to handle if I on bad mood to you, like really bad mood to you, and then did I going out like escape myself or not? Kebanyakan sih kalau misalkan aku marah itu, aku kalau marah nggak bisa kayak nyerocos gitu ngomong aja. Jadi buat aku kalau aku lagi marah itu. Jadi kalau untuk aku, kalau aku lagi marah itu, aku biasanya suka nggak mau ngomong. Jadi benar-benar let myself angry gitu. Jadi biarinlah marah kalau misalkan mau 2 jam, 3 jam. Pokoknya yang pasti aku selalu bilang ke suami kalau aku tuh masih marah sama dia. Dan aku masih nggak mau ngomong sama dia, kasih aku waktu gitu. Nanti kalau aku udah mau ngomong, kalau aku udah agak siap untuk bicara, baru nanti aku bakalan kontak dia gitu. Jadi kadang-kadang nggak secara langsung, karena kan kalau emosi suka pengen nyerocos gitu atau ngomong gitu. Jadi kadang-kadang aku suka SMS dia atau kirim pesan agak panjang gitu dikit. Marahnya kenapa? Nah dari situ lumayan deh gitu. Tapi kalau untuk masalah pundungan itu kalau bahasa Indonesia apa ya, sensitif gitu, jadi pergi gitu, tiba-tiba kabur gitu, enggak, aku nggak bakalan kabur dari masalah. Jadi selalu aku hadapi, karena walaupun balik lagi ya masalah itu tetap ada gitu. Jadi harus the next question. Tips for LDR, long distance relationship. Do you have any?
I don't have much experience about this. One time I have with her, and oh my god, it was nightmare. The tips: don't write every day 2 times or 4 times a day. You know, it's really annoying. You know, depends what like that person you, for me. Mm-hmm. What that person do? If that person is totally holiday and not do anything, then maybe he more available for this kind of communication. But if the person really have meeting a lot, business, then maybe he will be not happy to get a lot of message, you know. And better you asking that person how often it will be good for you to communication and what time. Better you have a schedule when in the morning, what every time? Morning or every evening you will be meet in the same time in Zoom and talk to each other. I think it's much better. And you always together, and then you have LDR for some moment. Enjoy this time, like get holiday from yourself. It's good, you know. If you're long time there, then
communication in the right times. Yeah,
have to communication have to be super quality. No any gadget. Nobody bother you. You just drink tea, eating together is good. You know, more engaged to each other. And also remember that you cannot be make a family LDR. How long LDR have to be finished? For my opinion, is cannot be forever LDR. It's not that quality of relationship people deserve. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because
for some period of time, like half year, let's say,
Okay. Or 1 year mostly.
Or 1 year, okay. But if not, this happens every year, you know.
Ya, kalau buat aku sih tips untuk LDR itu yang pertama komunikasi, karena komunikasi itu paling penting. Jadi harus ada komitmen dengan pasangan. Jam berapa, waktunya kapan untuk teleponan. Jadi di saat mereka kerja atau ngelakuin sesuatu, kamu nggak mengganggu gitu deh. Untuk jadi nggak ada salah paham gitu loh, karena udah ada komitmen jam sekian untuk telepon. Dan juga untuk ke yang paling penting sih, kayaknya kalau LDR jangan sesekali kayak misalkan itu jadi boring gitu. Kalau misalkan kalian ceritain hal yang sama kayak, eh segedang apa, kamu udah makan apa belum, kayak gitu-gitu tuh udah kayaknya oke lah sometime, tapi nggak hanya setiap hari pertanyaannya diawali dengan itu gitu. Jadi harus more interest, kayak ceritain something yang interesting buat dia denger gitu. Gitu sih kalau buat aku tipsnya. Karena aku juga enggak begitu banyak pengalaman tentang LDR ya. Cuman that is the way only, kalaupun aku jauh dari suami berapa hari gitu di luar kota atau lagi ada bisnis di luar seharian gitu, kadang jarang yang nemuin waktu. Pokoknya harus tahu jam berapa aku bisa SMS dia gitu atau telepon. Next question. Okay. What is the different character between each other?
Us?
For you first. I mean, what you see the different in me and you?
Character is quite similar. Us is quite similar. We both introvert, people who like be lonely, quiet, and I think it's really very similar character. Maybe I'm like more active than her. I'm more often going like trekking or picnic. Like I'm more can be active. Like she very easy to physically tired. She very.
Oh really? Yes. And who always have exercise in the morning?
Yeah, I think they should do. I mean, if you're going out, it's so easy to comparing. Maybe I don't know to what I'm thinking. Yeah, to be.
Maybe you mean I more easy to complain, like easy to.
She more home girl. She more home girl than I'm home boy.
Okay, kalau menurutku sih, perbedaan aku sama dia itu perbedaannya kayak lebih ke kayak yang dia tadi bilang. Mungkin aku lebih ke friendly life-nya kurang, kayak dia itu seneng sekali punya temen yang memang dia mau belajar gitu ke orang lain gitu. Kalau aku tuh nggak terlalu begitu, aku lebih suka temen tuh milih-milih gitu, dan cuman sedikit gitu temennya itu, tapi berkualitas banget. Tapi dia lebih suka belajar, jadi dia lebih suka banyak temen dan lebih mau belajar gitu. Kalau keluar pun ketemu orang baru dia begitu. Kalau aku nggak terlalu begitu. Itu sih kalau aku bedanya. Terus yang lainnya, I think is the different is aku suka bangun lebih pagi. Dia nggak. Dia still masih pagi sih, cuman beda gitu. Nggak bangun sama. Tapi kita tidur sama jam yang sama. Gitu. Ya, yeah. About wake up be different. And about food, untuk makanan dia itu suka yang berkuah. Kalau aku suka yang agak kayak between lah, berkuah atau enggak. Tapi dia enggak terlalu suka kayak terlalu Asia banget gitu, apalagi Indonesia banget. Enggak terlalu ya Indonesia. It's just few, maybe how many you like. Just nasi goreng and not every time.
Maybe I like 10 dish from all.
10 dish from all Indonesia.
Sebuntut, rawon, I like.
Okay, makanan sih agak beda banget ya, beda banget. Jadi kalau aku masak itu kadang-kadang harus nanya dia dulu, mau nggak kalau aku masak ini gitu. Itu sih. Terus next question. What do you think? Why LDR so difficult?
Because you can send each other more information when you talk in real life. Even you talk in real life, you already like misunderstanding. And
how about
online,
you, Lucia?
less information, less, more person can be understand you wrong way. So yeah. This is the difficult one.
Yeah. Okay, next question. How you fix it the problem, but you the one that your couple thinking that you are the mistake, even you really have mistake.
I think that if you have mistake, just tell that you did mistake.
We never have this.
It's what the benefit, like, yeah. To be always right, then you will be always fighting with each other. Even mm-hmm. when you really will be right, nobody will be believe you. So if I'm wrong, I tell I'm wrong. But if I feel I'm right, I tell that I feel I'm right. So this is the key, I think.
Yeah, kita tuh berdua kayak selalu kalau misalkan siapapun yang salah gitu ya, kalau kita lagi bicara, kalau aku yang salah, misalkan aku yang bilang kayak misalkan ya kesalahanku di sini gini gitu, dikasih tahu apa kesalahanku dan tentunya apologize ya, tapi di situ juga jadi pasangan kita juga pasti ngerasa itu gitu, karena dia juga nggak mungkin, karena di dalam komunikasi pasangan itu sih nggak ada yang menang, intinya itu kamu yang salah atau kamu yang benar pun nggak akan ada yang menang di situ, nggak ada winner, it's no happy winner right in this
yes,
situation,
no winner,
so you have to fix it the
you
problem,
you win win or loss
lah, yeah exactly. Jadi kalau misalkan masalahnya nggak selesai berarti kalian lost gitu, kalian kalah dua-duanya, tapi kalau misalkan masalahnya terselesaikan berarti kalian win win, kalian menang dua-duanya gitu.
I also next. Will be add that if person ask this question then mm-hmm. probably feel himself not secure in this relationship, so mm-hmm. come back to our advice before
the first
yeah
one. Mm-hmm.
And also to say I'm mistake, sorry, it's not like I'm sorry, it's not have to be like this, it's you can be just come and say, remember our talking last time, this about this, yeah, I thinking again and I understand that I was did mistake,
yeah,
I'm sorry for this, that's all,
because you already know? Happened
you
and
need
then,
to be yeah? Shy, you need to be feel shame,
yes,
say
exactly.
Sorry, it's not feel shame. Everybody can do mistake, just tell yes I did mistake, yeah, sorry.
And actually, this is some of our solution as well. Yeah, every time when we have a problem, when we really, really honestly, like, oh yeah, maybe we did something wrong or me doing something wrong, something like this. This is the way as well to get that really, you know, it cannot be happen again next and remind like. Improve ourselves, yeah, from this situation. Yeah, it's really good. Okay, this is the question almost finished. So, what's your thinking about your life for future?
I already told my dream, what I have.
So
dream.
That one, yeah.
This
connecting.
Is my
okay.
way, my destination.
What the tradition you have in your relationship and why you like that tradition?
I like Monday tradition, we go on bicycle in the morning, have breakfast in the restaurant, evening we have romantic dinner and see movie. Also traditions, the way to talk, safety way and comfortable way to give
pillow
feedback
talk.
To each other, mm-hmm. yes. With timer, it's really good video.
Yes, yeah.
Yes,
really in our good. Tradition, that is
yeah,
the best
really
one.
Good.
Yeah.
Many good things. We make full day of the things what we really like, and we have our schedule, which is I really enjoy to follow. And I like my wake up routine, I like my morning, lunch, evening routine, whole day. And my day can be different, stay home or going outside. I really
but
love
same wake
everything.
Up and
yeah, wake up
sleep.
And sleep time is mostly the same.
Yeah, buat aku juga, aku paling suka Monday routine. Kayak Monday tradition, itu tuh harus banget. Jadi kita harus spend time, kayak quality time. kemana atau walaupun di rumah nonton dan ya benar-benar without gadget gitu. Padahal nggak seharian itu, jadi kita cuma 3 atau 4 jam, tapi that is really quality time. I really like that the most in from our tradition. Dan ngomong dengan timer itu sih, jadi kita tuh kayak ngasih kesempatan nggak terlalu banyak informasi yang kita dapat kalau lagi quality time gitu. Jadi itu berguna banget. Good, now is pertanyaan pamungkas. So in my podcast always have 3 final question.
Okay.
And this is for you. No.
Okay, good.
So the first one is what's a big dream goal for you in the 5 years? what need to get? And if something place is where like this.
I told my big dream, big goal, but the short dream I don't wanna telling because you know it give energy from me to outside, you know, like follow her YouTube, Instagram, you gonna see what we will be get, you know. I like what happening and at the moment. I like where we're going together and what will be in the middle of this is depends of our productivity and yeah, like belief in ourselves.
So in 5 years, you wanna just happy, yeah?
Not just happy. I have things I don't wanna share to public at the moment.
So a lot of things.
Yeah, I have things. Okay. Every year we make a dream list.
Sacred.
Just.
Jadi follow terus sampai 5 tahun.
Yeah.
Okay, the next question is good. The answer is okay because this is something private for you. So maybe me is okay to know, but not in the camera or listen.
She know.
Yeah. Untuk pertanyaan yang kedua, the second question is what you see your family in 10 years?
In 10 years, I see that we have 3 kids, beautiful family, we traveling together around the world, we have a really good time. Yeah, I have my big dream that every person in my family have their big idea, big dream, you know? Every kid, Donna, you know, I wanna each person be super excited to do something for himself and for a community. If this happen, then I'm sure the life will be so wonderful and we'll be have everything. Healthy, respect from people and money and freedom.
Final question, the one more question. That's if you have choice to be choose only one nationality in this world, like Indonesia or Ukraine, which one you choose?
Which citizen I can be?
Yes, only these two, from these two countries. Hopefully guys, you're not here. Somebody hungry.
I think I will be not change anything. I will be choose Ukrainian because I know how it is. I like everything, and I don't know what gonna be if I be Indonesian person.
Yeah. Like, buat aku juga.
At the moment for sure I will be not change anything because I like to stay here, and for the like. Who I born from beginning, like I don't know how my life gonna be if I Indonesian. So yeah. I like everything what I have today, and I like.
And as well, you life. See a possibility in this country much more bigger, ya.
Yeah? Yes.
Buat aku sih, aku juga saat ini nggak ada kepikiran untuk ganti nationality. Jadi Indonesia is I will be choose Indonesia because it's my hometown and my family there. Dan juga yang paling penting sih, we still be together,
yes.
With this different country.
I will be choose, I understand, I will be choose the citizen of Earth. This, I would like to have passport of citizens of Earth. With this passport, I go any country, everywhere. I can be work everywhere. I can be have rules everywhere. This is what I will be choose. So more higher than just citizens of peace of the land, you know.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow, we done, we good. Ah. Thank you, terima kasih teman-teman yang udah mendengarkan sampai selesai. Semua yang kita ceritain di sini adalah pertanyaan-pertanyaan dari kalian. Jadi kita udah jawab hampir semua karena yang kebanyakan ini yang sama pertanyaannya. Jadi aku bikinnya disatuin gitu. And for you, thank you so much for coming in my podcast. That is a special guest for me. Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you guys to see all this long video.
Or listen.
I hope you take something useful for yourself, and I hope your quality of life will be better.
Ya, yeah, makasih banyak buat teman-teman yang mendengarkan podcast ini. Guys, nanti juga nggak bakalan kalah serunya, bakalan mendatangkan orang-orang yang sangat interest banget, yang sangat menarik banget untuk kalian simak. Karena ya di masalah hubungan ini nggak akan ada hentinya, dan kita sama-sama mendengarkan dari pengalaman orang lain, moga dari pengalaman kita. Dan terima kasih untuk kalian yang sudah kasih pertanyaan buat kita, buat suami saya juga, dan moga jawabannya kalian puas dengan jawabannya. Dan terima kasih untuk menyimak dan mendengarkan podcast ini. Dari jawaban tadi kita itu bisa kalian ambil hikmahnya atau sisi positifnya, dan moga kalian suka. Ya, segitu aja dari kami. Aku Donna dan
Igor.
Bold of Self. So, sampai ketemu lagi di podcast selanjutnya. Dah. Because already long time. Where is my pen? Apple pen.
Why are we without mask? Now it's quarantine.
Don't worry. They just hear my podcast, not see.